What is good, guys? It is Leon from Sneaker Clinic, and thank you for tuning into my channel and of course clicking into this video. Hey, okay. I wish just like money's falling from the tree, I wish shoes like these, like sick shoes, would fall from the ceiling, you know? Then I don't need to go on freaking online and cop the shoes or go in store and line up, you know? Alright, this is not a clickbait video. This is actually not a tutorial. This is just like a quick kind of overview of what I've done so far, which I'll get to that in a bit. If you don't even know what these are, oh my god, like, shame on you, or maybe you're just too young, right? This is the Penny Hardaway 6, I believe. Yes, I'm surprised that I actually managed to cop this particular colorway, this model even, 5 years ago. 2015, right? 2015, yeah. This came out like 2015. There was a blue colorway as well, and I think there was other colorways, but if I had blue and red, I would totally alternate them, right? But this is sick. I love red. You guys should already know. If you don't know, well, that's just too bad. Red's one of my favorite colors. But this black shirt, same black shirt, different day. Who cares? So what I did with these, I basically did a full exterior clean. I also did the interior clean. The insoles are not here. They're at work. I did, I think, like 3-4 times just because... little bit of odor. But what is the point of this video? This video is just me telling you kind of what to do if you're interested in restoring or kind of re-dyeing the suede, all right? It is totally different than dyeing leather. Here, I will show you guys. I use Angelus, all right? They have leather dye as well as suede dye. Just don't use leather dye for suede and vice versa. I haven't tried using leather dye on suede. I will probably do a test down the road on one of my shoes, or definitely not my customer's shoes. Now you can see on this little photo, this is the before. Oh my god, this PIP picture is not giving me any space. All right, so you'll see the freaking photo right there. That's how I used to look like before. Getting back to this, step one, what I did was I actually cleaned the shoes twice, all right? First full clean, let it dry, bring the nap back, and then a second clean, you know, just make sure everything is all good to go, right? Because that's one of the most important things, is making sure that the surface is all prepped. And then I started testing a small area, an inconspicuous area. I don't even know if I said that word right, but yeah, like you can see from this camera and the lighting, whatever, it is a huge difference. This right side, it has not been dyed, okay? This one has been, right? This has been pretty much soaked with the red dressing. Now putting it closer, let me zoom in a little bit. I know that the red does pop up too much, but look at this huge difference, right? Now this original colorway, it's university red, but because Angelus, they don't really have a university red color, they just have red. From what I'm aware, I just tested it out with red and I think it really pops. It's pretty cool actually. This kind of brings the shoe back to life. Like, it is a huge difference. Side by side, look at that. This kind of looks like a faded pink. I just did a once kind of layer on this shoe. Let it dry, of course, and then bring the nap back. And then I did a second kind of like suede dye on it. And this is how it looks like right now. This is two coats. And then let's zoom in a little bit. See the difference, right?
Big difference.
Okay, my voice, gotta really, really stop using the high pitch. Now, the Angelus, each of the dyes, they do come with this crazy nice cotton ball. It's not cotton ball, this little stick here that you can dip it in, right? And then apply it on there. I use the brush, the paintbrush, just because that way I can control how much is on the bristles. The box actually do have this little opening, which is not meant for you to go peek-a-boo. It's meant for you to freaking put this thing on, and when you're doing your work, you're not gonna accidentally knock over, you know, the bottle, right? If you just do it like this and the cap's open, oh my god, it's gonna die. Like, your surface is gonna dye your clothes, your skin, and you don't want that, right? I learned my lesson the hard way for regular paints. Wow, make sure you do put the cap back on every time. It's gonna get messy. But yeah, these are permanent. So definitely be careful if you're gonna dye the shoes. I will do a actual tutorial down the road, right? When I have time, I will actually show you guys how to get this other side that's not done, right? The right side of the shoe looking like the left side of the shoe. For now, I'm just gonna use these as in-store display purposes. So any of the customers or people interested to kind of look at the before and after, they can actually get a in-hand kind of like feel, right? A visual kind of look. I don't want people touching my shoes too much, so maybe I'm just gonna put it in a glass case. A little tip. I've seen YouTube videos out there of people just doing a very quick kind of like, hey, I'm gonna show you how to do this, right? And then I read the comments and they're like, you don't even know what you're doing, right? So what I've seen is someone using the suede dressing, they dip this thing in there and then it's like drenched and then they just started soaking you know, like the suede. And I'm like, oh my God, is that even the right way to do it? I don't think it's the right way. I think you're supposed to make sure that you kind of like get some of the suede off, right, from the brush that you're using, you know? Make sure it's not super soaking wet before you start soaking that nice sexy suede, right? I use a paintbrush because, like I said, I can control it. The only downside is it does take more time, so you gotta be very patient. I will tell you in the tutorial later, but right now, since you guys already know the huge difference, what I've done is any of the rubber materials when I was doing my second coat, I taped it off, right? Because I know that they're going to have a chance of dyeing that and you don't want that, right? These black lace loops, even though they are black fly wire, I still protected it with tape, right? The corners here. Right, for this particular shoe right here, I know that my brush will have a little bit of issue kind of getting into there. So I taped it off just those particular areas so that I can protect the foam posite material and the midsole there. You can choose to tape the entire shoe. But for me, like I said in my other restoration, the Do the Right Thing Air Jordan 3, I have a steady hand, so I have confidence that I'm not gonna make too much of a mistake. Oh my God, ugh. Fragmented English. Okay, yeah, that's why I got a D minus in English class. So there it is. Hit that like button. Please subscribe to this channel. I'm going to do my best to, you know, make cool content for you guys. Using leather dye on suede or suede dye on leather. I made that boo-boo. I am kidding you not. Oh my God. Luckily, it is not my customer's shoes. It is my own personal pair. VC White Shox Raptors BB4s, actually. I was trying to paint the upper black. There are people there that are like, hey, you know what, if you use a leather dye as a base layer first and like before you paint the black paint on it, it's gonna be more durable, right? You don't have to, but I was kind of curious, so I accidentally used black suede dressing dye and then I was like brushing it on, you know, and then I'm like, why is it turning purple? Like, it's not going on black. And then I looked at the the bottle. That's when I realized it's suede dye and not leather dye. But yeah, I will do random tests, boo-boos, down the road. I don't know what kind of shoes I'm gonna use to test. Probably not my pair, maybe my friend's pair. Hey, wait a second. Maybe my customer doesn't want these shoes. Oh, what? Oh, it turned it into your own custom Air Jordan 5 Alternate Grapes. This is a very cool ceiling, by the way. All right, yo, so, okay, there's too many shoes in this video, it's gonna get confusing, but this video is only about the Air Penny 5s. All right, yeah, so for suede dyeing, just don't dye a shoe and expect the color to show up the way you want it to, because it is not like covering over something, right, like painting. Suede is a little bit more tricky, I guess. I don't have a lot of experience with suede dye, but down the road, you know, I'm gonna get more experience, I'm gonna get better and better, right, just like everybody out there. Yeah, for this pair of shoes, when I first saw it on the internet, I actually thought that this could pass as a custom sneaker. It's like somebody grabbed a white suede fives and just basically slapped a purple suede dressing on it. Sorry, getting distracted. Okay, yeah, this is more like it. Okay, Leon is out.